Kublai Khan received an ornate letter signed by Marco Polo. In Madrid, city of lost things, no item remains where it was set. If one drops his key in the dirt, he may never re-enter his home, and even if he manages to stoop and recover the key, he may rise to find a tulip garden where his house once stood. In complementary fashion, things lost by others are forever turning up. A pocket watch on a coffee table, a fond memory in your recollection. I even know of a prince who turned up in a prison cell. When he appealed to the guards for his release, he failed to find the crown on his head, and when he was asked his name, he searched his thoughts, but could not find it. Indeed, the only hope now for the release of this prince of Spain is for you to send back 300 ducats for his release. Of course, he will reward you handsomely once he is out. Yours truly, Marco. Kublai Khan cocked an eyebrow and declared before his court, "Hey everyone, looks like we're about to get ripped off by the guy who traded gold for paper." The court erupted in booming laughter. Italo Calvino, Invisible Cities 2, this time it's visible.
You can do it.
Go on, get... Don't look at me.
Through many births, I have wandered on and on, searching for, but never finding, a better deal than 0% APR on certified pre-owned vehicles. For trucks tougher than a drunk Marine, come to Mike's Pre-Owned, where we do the things that get things done.
Beep. 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 You're right there. I mean, beep. 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 Come on. Beep. 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 Yes, beep.
Can you hear me? I'm nothing but a rusty chunk of steel. You don't want nothing to do with me. All right. I'll tell you my story. It was June the 8th, 1947, gray morning, slightly foggy. I had my own practice then, and I was living higher than a cosmonaut on a stepladder. My hints were subtle, too, real subtle. Back then, they said, good old Hint Button. His hints could steal the tail off a weasel. Then they tossed me in the can. No what, no why, no how. Those were the mean times, when all the common sense in the world won't make a nickel to buy you a black coffee. I used rope to tie my pants, and pants to tie my shoes. I made do the way a man does, until one day, after stealing the socks off a fireplace, I caught my own look in a puddle of bootleg rye and realized I had to do what I'd never done before. I gave myself a hint. So that's me. I was nothing but a downtown crumb who dreamed of being a whole sandwich. Now I'm just another sloppy Joe. Come back when you got something. Come back when you got a good one. I'll tell you this, when life hauls off and hits me square in the speaker, I don't get mad and I don't give up. Over many nights of thinking hard and drinking hard, up till the morning lighting one cup of Joe with the smoldering butt of the last slug of rum, this is what I learned. When you're up against the
I believe in you. This is all you. Yeah, keep trying. Yeah, there's a trick to it, but you've got it. Yeah, maybe you can't do it. You can do it. I believe in you.
That's very original. It just needs more red, I think. No, try putting some more loops on it. It simply must have more loops. Imagine gravity is fractal, because light is just a wave, and gravity is just a wave. So imagine there's a big piece of glass that splits up gravity like a prism, so that there's, like, blue gravity and yellow gravity. And then somebody gets hit by the red gravity, and it makes them super heavy, so they have super strength, but, like, they're also really slow. And another guy gets hit by microwave gravity, so he's trying to zap everybody, and just when he's about to zap the main guy, we see a lady come out, and she turns out to be Ultraviolet Girl, and she has super speed, so she beats him. And it, like, also gave her giant cans. Thomas Pynchon, Gravity's Rainbow. The notion of two realities is uncomfortable, and in recent decades a genuine effort has been made to find the link between quantum and classical, so that we can have a single reality whose laws and rules are united at some deeper level. This brings us back to prayers. Let's say that a prayer is a classical event, or feels like one. You, a unique individual, have a particular request, which you voice in words that no one else is speaking at that instant. What if this classical event gets processed at a non-local level? The notion isn't far-fetched, because it seems that the mind-body link does consist of fluctuations at the quantum level. If this is so, then any thought, not just a prayer, has quantum implications. Deepak Chopra, A Spiritual Mystery, Does God Listen to Prayers? Part 2. A shipowner was about to send to sea a venerable old ship. He knew that her barnacled hull, however, had often needed repairs, and doubts were suggested to him that possibly she was not seaworthy. The conscientious old captain thought at once to have her thoroughly refitted, even though it should put him at great expense. Before the ship sailed, however, he managed to stifle these bothersome misgivings, and said to himself that she had gone safely through so many voyages. You can only get good at chess if you love the game. Grandmaster Bobby Fischer. Not only is the novice unable to perceive the board as the master does, but the master cannot perceive the board as the novice does. A master cannot see the bishop on e3 as a chunk of dead wood any more than you can look at your best friend's face and see a meaningless matrix of colors and shapes. The master once saw the board like this, but now there is no going back. International Master Stuart Rachels, The Reviled Art. I hate chess. I hate chess. I hate chess. World champion, Bobby Fischer.
Thank you.
The obelisk of knowledge. The obelisk of knowledge. Shnilandwick's little bite. Stones of reflection. Oh wait, it's a giant cup.
This has got to be some kind of whiz with the computers. Good stack of pennies. I would never hurt you. Let's see. Easy one. How's this? Nerd shit. Nerd shit. Now that's a book. Ah, one more puzzle before retirement.